The Picasso Museum in Paris welcomes between 500 and 700,000 visitors every year, two-thirds of whom are foreigners from all over the world. But not everyone is able to travel abroad and come to the Picasso Museum. So today is the Picasso Museum that's coming to them and touring the world. The first and only other time we organized a touring exhibition was in 1980. It had three stops in New York, London, and Northern Germany. And now, after more than 30 years, this exhibit is a special opportunity because it's the first time that the Picasso Museum's collection is presented in Canada, in Toronto. The exhibit is retrospective. It is deliberately scientific and didactic. Picasso's different periods are presented chronologically so we can see all the moments of fusion, of transference, and from one period to the next, all the keys that permitted him to revolutionize himself. Pablo Picasso is first and foremost a philosopher. He's a man who observed his own time, but I think we have a very bad perception of him as a person because of the image the media portrayed of him in the 1950s. But Picasso is something else. He's not simply an image, and he played the clown with the media quite often. He dressed up, he really liked to pull the wool over their eyes, as they say, because it was a way for him to protect his work and his works in progress that no one was supposed to see before completion. What's important is that Picasso wanted to approach art as the true understanding of reality. We all have this curiosity, as in the famous story Bluebeard. We open the forbidden door, we transgress taboos, we eat the forbidden artistic fruit, and this transgression is what Picasso's work is all about. And that's why he's so dear to us all, no matter your age or your place in the world. This is really an extraordinary, exceptional occasion. There won't be another exhibit like this for a long time, perhaps for yet another 30 years. And so we should all take advantage of it and really experience this exhibition, enter in a dialogue with it to attempt our own revitalization of the world at the beginning of this 21st century. I think it's an opportunity, and it should be seized.